Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Radically Loved Radio. We are at the Mod Pod virtual studio, and we have a very special guest today. Queen Afua is with us. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me. I'm delighted.
I'm so excited to chat with you. I mean, I'm very familiar with your work, and it just so happens that this is the day after International Women's Day. And I saw your Instagram live that you did, and I was so excited to chat with you today, because there was so much of what you said during that live chat. I was trying to keep all my questions for you today concise, but I guess I'm going to have to take what I can get. And there was something so beautiful that you said. We've talked about motherhood on this podcast a lot. I've had a difficult couple years with fertility personally. So this has been kind of a long journey for me, and I've openly talked about it. And in fact, reading your book, Sacred Woman, has actually helped me get into a more accepting place, into a more healing space. And hearing you talk about your kids yesterday, it just really filled me up. You said that your youngest was your bones, your oldest was your spirit, and then your daughter was your heart. And I just wanted to take some time just to talk a little bit about what that means for you, and just the importance of us being able to celebrate women, especially during this time.
Well, my children represented different aspects of myself, because your children are an extension of you. You think, this is what I've learned. They are the sum total of whatever you were going through in the time of conception, the time of carrying them and bringing them into the world. So I related to them, I related with them from those places, and they have a relationship with me from the bones, from the heart, and from the spirit that had been so consistent over the years. They came as my deepest lessons, like in your face lessons, and telling you exactly how they feel about your journey, where you might have been like, everything is great, everything is wonderful, we're doing this, we're healing everybody. And they tell you as they mature, this is what you did not do. This is what you actually created. This is exactly what I was going through and feeling while you were going through and serving everyone. Okay. So I studied them and me as my reflection, as reading. Now talk about the eldest, Supernova. He is the spirit, because as a child, as a teenager, I could go to him and say, listen, I have a question, go within. I can say, go within. He closes his eyes and I'll ask him any question and he'll just say it. And I say, okay, thank you very much. And he'll just go about playing with whatever he's doing. And he was always in tune, that's the Aquarian. So I can ask him about Sacred Woman. I can ask him about, should I be traveling right now? You know, you go to readers. I developed it in the children, my children. Then with the middle, the heart, I can have a heart attack any moment with the girl child. And they go into deeper, it's like doing a sweat lodge. They make a sweat lodge, I've done many of them. When it's co-ed, it's a different experience. It's really easy. When it's a woman's sweat, it goes to the core of your soul. So the heart, she needs more hugs. She needs more attention. She needs more time. She needs a greater understanding. That's the heart. And because I'm running and doing, she lets me know, you're not giving enough to the feminine aspect of yourself. Then I have the youngest one, the bones. He represents the foundation. He is going to stick with this work no matter what. Earthquake, emotional earthquake, a mudslide, changing the business from one location to the next, one staff member to the next, one concept to the next, on the road. Those bones are never going to give up. He's a Capricorn. He's just not going to give up. He's not going to say, I need time out. I will not get time out if it knocks me out. I'm gonna still be there. So they represent those parts of me. And according to what is needed, they'll show up and they'll give me their take on life. So that's been the relationship with these souls that have entered into through my being, you know? So I get that. And all my three children, they are into this healing, like to the light, to the death, to the beginning, to the end. They just don't let up. And I watch other healers, and I haven't seen other healers have their children that deep, but I have, for me, I kept them strapped to me because I was what they call, quote unquote, a single parent. I left their birth father, but you know, it's a community of men who help, and women that they call auntie and Bob, that help to strengthen them and instill good qualities in them. But I kept them very close, and I fought for them their whole life because I didn't believe in the vaccine. I inundated them with whole foods and juicing from very young, and minerals and vitamins and all and everything. So I did, they, you know, the first one had one shot, the others never did. So I knew that the inoculation or the boosting of the immune system with food is medicine. That's what I did. And I sent them to public school. That was like the death. So I always find a cultural school or a spiritual school that gave education. So I was always, and my family didn't get me at all. They get me, and they pretty much don't get me now, my blood family. So I was fighting. I said, wait a minute. I came in the kitchen one time and I saw a chicken bone on one of my children's plate. I said, wait a minute. I think I went, okay. It was a battlefield for me. Motherhood was not just, you know, meditation and prayer. Well, that's what my life was. But it wasn't just that. It was, you know, I was fighting this, I was almost fighting the system. There was so much I didn't believe in. And all the toxic food in the community and the junk and the fast and the fry. So it was just a battlefield. And my children, I kept them close and they stay in the healer one way or the other.
Yeah, what was that like to be that anomaly in your family, to be that the person that was, you know, outside of what the norm was? I mean, I grew up in a very big Hispanic family where it was very centered around, you know, eating and not talking about your feelings and everything very rigid. And so I was that anomaly, you know. I was into spirituality and I wanted to learn about yoga and I wanted to have these conversations and I wanted to eat organic foods. And it was very hard, you know, and that's your community.
Yes. Well, my blood family, I had 9 aunts. I have 5 now, but I had 9 aunts and 5 uncles. So I had a big family and cousins. I think maybe 2 out of my huge family that are in this healing animal. It took them years to get there. So it was just me and my children. And my mother came years later to get understanding. My father, I was taking care of him in the 70s and 80s. And he got it. He got the healing and he believed in it. So that was great. My mother didn't quite get it, but she supported me. Whatever I was doing, she was going to support me. She helped me by manufacturing my products and raising my children. She invested a building for me. She put a building for me to put my wellness center in. So my mother was, she would finance my vision with this wellness, although she couldn't get, got really older, and this healing had to save her life. She's still here in her body, she's 96. So that has been a blessing. So I'm still strange to the family, but during this pandemic, I don't look so strange anymore.
Right?
Family and friends are calling up and saying, what do I need to do? What was that you said 10 years ago? You know, it's a wake up call because, you know, when the hospital in the very beginning, especially, they didn't have machines, they didn't have help for the people. They said, well, unless you're critical, go home. And people said, now what, go home to what? I'm sick, you know? And so people had to wake up and started to use Buddhist medicine in their kitchen labs. And so now the world is more holistic. That's what I'm observing through this crisis.
Yeah, I mean, that's
all of our business.
It's been such a, there's been such a huge upheaval in the last year. How has it impacted you and your business and your life?
Actually, I have never seen anything like this. This is a phenomenon. My business has grown 10 times over. The moment that it hit, well, it was happening. I was coming to the airport at the end of February, myself, Queen Esther, my right hand, and Tahuti Films. We did a film, a documentary of my work in Kemet, miscalled Egypt. And so 60 women were on our way back to the States, and I'm looking at masks. And I'm saying, well, people just kind of protect themselves from the air is that polluted. And I was observing that. And then here, February to March, bam, it hit. And next thing I know, I was telling people how to boost up their immune system and clear out their lungs. And then when April came in, then with how I responded to it, I organized. And I said, there's a book that I put out called Planet Heal 2 years ago, as if I knew what was about to happen. And I have 76 healers in that book, acupuncturists, yoginis, vegan chefs, crystal healers, midwives, doctors, color therapists. So a number, a wide range of different practices and disciplines. I call these up like my friends that I grew up through and with, and then that book. So I asked all of them to come on board for 21 days, need a 21 day vigil to help to protect our immune system. So everyone would come up for an hour power in the mornings. I would tell them what to do. And I think by the fourth session, and they would come on two or two at a time. And one of the presenters, who she has the peace movement, Stop the Violence, the Gun Violence, Erica Ford is her name. She said, Queen, you have to give us the protocols. And as soon as I hung that phone, I knew it because I was saying the same thing over and over again. You know, take your ginger, take your vitamin C, take your green juice, take a healing bath. You know, I was telling to take all these things to do. And what I ended up doing is I put the protocols together and it was free. And I put them on my website, they're still there. And then I made some copies of them. And I was in a large complex at the time. And I took my name out. I put the protocols on everybody's door. So whoever was connected, you know, somebody's gonna get it and heal their lives. So that's how I responded. And I've been just teaching. And then what happened after all of that, I was so hyped up about, I'm so glad you called me. I got a call from Black Girls Rock, from Beverly Bond. I went for her for years for a call, for a connection. So she said, Queen, we're afraid, we're scared. We don't know what to do. We're petrified. I said, oh, I'm so glad you called. I know exactly what to do. She said, well, could you come on and speak to us? You know, it was like an hour presentation between her doing music. And I was so fired up. I was so extremely fired up. So they said, could you please stay with us? Stay for 5 months. I took them to the 21-day detox and a few thousand people went through that. So that's how I responded. I've been actually so empowered. I've been helping so many others get empowered. And one thing I noticed that sacred women were not having problems. Mm. Those who went through that book, they understood what to do for themselves. They was living the life. And they knew what to do for their families. And their families were calling them for help. And they were able to help them. And now that we started Band Hill, I said, well, as warriors, it's the same thing. So those who are my circle, they are most empowered. And they become entrepreneurs. And they're starting to make more financial blessings are coming to them. So yes, the bottom fell out. And Brother Floyd was taken out, his life was taken, and the whole world saw it. Everybody came together in defense. So this is extreme wake up. We get like a little nudge, you know, pat, and then you get thrown off the bed. And that's what we are.
Yeah, we definitely did get thrown off the bed in an aggressive way, I think. But I think it's, in my opinion, in my perspective, I think we needed that wake up call. I mean, I grew up during the 92 LA riots. So I saw the intensity and the healing that needed to happen back then. It's almost like, okay, guys, like now we can't ignore this anymore. There is things that are in the system that need to be healed, that need to be attended to. And so I love that you're saying that the sacred women, like the people that read this book, which by the way, the 20th anniversary edition is out. For those of you, oh, thank you, JD. Mod Pod, we got the Mod Pod Pro crew today. We got the picture of the book. It is so incredible. And as I said earlier, you know, I've been going through this fertility journey myself. And I think over the last 2 years, you're so right with what this book does. And there is such a deep level of care and nurturing and encouragement that you've written about in this book. And I really do believe that knowledge is power. And this is a guide to every woman who wants to connect to the deepest parts of themselves, to create healing, to understand their body, to learn about breathing techniques, to learn about, creating sacred movement for everything. And so I'm so grateful that you created this, first of all. And I obviously can see why so many people follow you, because you're incredible. Hello. But I think that now, especially with everything that we just said,
yes,
it's such a great time, right, to put the focus into supporting women and to empowering women to, how is it, like, take control of their health, right?
Yes, absolutely. Well, there's an affirmation. I am so happy that it's in the beginning of the book. Because as I was I've been doing Sacred Women like 15 years before the book came out. And then 20 years now. And it's amazing because it's on the bestsellers list 20 years later. Okay. But I'm so happy that the book was able to be opened up again. And I use this affirmation I would like to share with you, if I may.
Please.
This is an affirmation that came from the ancient Nile Valley world, from Kemet. And that is the seat of holistic health. We call it New Age. No, it's from antiquity. And in my research, I found that from color therapy to yoga practice, meditation, Reiki, massage therapy, reflexology, hydrotherapy, astrology, all of that is ancient, is from antiquity. So this prayer was given to the women from the beginning of time, and it's holy for right now. And this will allow women to know that they're the healers of their home and their community. Say, go ahead and get their studies, get shored up, get strengthened, get detoxed, and get empowered with this affirmation to support. So, we are the women who lighten the darkness. We have come to lighten the darkness. It is lightened. We have overcome the destroyers. We are there for those who weep, who hide their faces, who sunk down. They looked upon us then. We are the women. We are the healers. We are the women. We are the healers. We are the women. We are the healers. So we don't have to look outside of ourselves for healing any further. We can look within and bring nature into your life, activate nature, because we are nature. Air, fire, water, earth is my work. I work with the elements. You can tap into the nature outside, connect to nature inside, and then it spreads out to your family and to your friends, and we activate that affirmation. So this is definitely the time of empowerment for the women. And if you empower the women, you empower the family. The women are the bottom line for wellness. Even if a woman doesn't know what she's doing, even if the husband doesn't know that he did, she's that one. When I would see couples come to me, they both was looking to get well together, I would start telling them, this is what you need to do, this is how you need to do, this is what you need to eat, this is what you need to do. I'd give him a list. And then he would tell his wife, it never failed. He said, honey, did you get that? Did you get that information? Did you get what she said? Do we have that in the house? Do we have a juicer? And she would always say, of course, yes, we have that. Uh-huh, don't worry about that. Okay, we'll get that. We do have that, that's fine. She would have all the information. And he would be humble to her. And that's how it goes. We're the healers, we're the ones. So that connects to your womb and our womb healing. I am the mother of womb wellness. I claim and I accept that I've been on this path, doing this for 50 years every single day. There's another sister, elder, that I would say, who's also one of the mothers, because it's not one, and that's Dr. June Pulchram. She was a master surgeon, and she put down her scalp. We're both like wellness salute. We're both soldiers on the wellness team. And she put down her surgical work, and she picked up the herbs and nature, and she works with balancing the brain, connecting the brain connects to the uterus. So the state of mind also connects to the uterus. And I also said the state of mind is connected to the womb of the heart, The womb of the mind, which creates the condition of the womb. Whether it's passed out through the DNA, you're carrying your mama's womb. You're carrying your grandmother's womb. You're carrying your auntie's womb. And you are the daughter, you're carrying all of that. So as you do your healing work and your processing, your detoxification, and get your menstrual flow in divine order and pour and inundate yourself with all forms of green and do and add to your yoga practice, womb yoga, dance some of the poses, you'll have no more womb issues. I'm so confident in what I'm saying because I work with so many women and they feel so good about claiming their wombs. Now you can go see your OBGYN and I recommend every OBGYN read the book and some have and some have quietly, you know, integrated a practice and to teaching the women. But this is the era. And this is not the era of being dependent. This is the era of being interdependent, connected to yourself, connected to community of women healing themselves. And we have no more womb issues once we do that. That's my take.
Yeah, I mean, if only we could all get, only everybody just do that. Everybody could get on board. You know, one of
they're
the
they're getting on board, don't you?
It's true.
Are you seeing it in your practice?
Yes.
Yeah,
you're right. You're right.
They're coming.
We've yeah, been you're right. You're
We've
right.
Been waiting. We've
you're
been
right.
working and healing, and they're coming.
You're right. You know, you actually talked about yoga, and I know that you have your a form of yoga that you created. Can you tell us a little bit about that for the people mm-hmm. listening?
Yeah, but it's so funny because it seems so new to everyone because it is. But I've been practicing this yoga for 25 years, and in the book, you see 25 movements. It's actually 108. Which is the number for global transformation. So when one actually sees it, it starts transforming you as soon as you see it. The poses are come, they come off the walls of Kemet. They are literally glyphs and it wakes up your right brain and it wakes up your subconscious mind to that medicine. So the movements are medicine. So whether you're doing the lotus hands, which means coming out of the mud of pain and suffering, into the illuminated, pure, clean woman, or whether you're dormant at the cobra, and that represents that you're waking up your medicine, left and right brain, to whether you're sitting in the mother os, when you're sitting in your seat of squat, sitting in your seat of power, or you're stretching out a mesh kinet as you birth your purpose. So all the movements are dealing with the elements in nature, or they're dealing with the glyphs of medicine. So these poses actually activate your subconscious mind in your inner power. And it has saved my life. When I don't do my own movements, I feel old age trying to get a hold of me. I'm not having it. So I have to do it for my own salvation, but at the same time, for women. So we work with breath. Of course, the breath is the foundation. Relaxation, tuning in, going inside yourself, and going in and doing your surgery on yourself. We work with the tone, the sound, and we call on Hesi to chant as we go through pose. So there's 69 womb yoga poses and 39 womb yoga dance movements. So that's when you then start. So the poses are very smooth and you flow. It's a poem. It's like the Mahabharata. That's what I consider it as. It's a living poem. So you really, all those movements are actually one movement when you master them. You don't know when one ends or one begins. It just flows, it just flows, it just flows. It flows like the Nile, it just flows into one. And you begin into the breath. You've done about 1,000 breaths, 1,000 of breath by the time you get through all the movements. So it's something you should do every day. But I would say if someone said, this is too much, can I just give me a few movements? One movement. This will take care of everything. Lay down flat in your bed and put 3 pillows at the foot of the bed. This is part of it. 1, 2, 3 on top, stack the pillows and keep those pillows there because you're gonna do this every day for the rest of your life. Put your legs over those pillows before you get out of bed and just rub your hands together, take them quiet. And then massage your womb center from right ovary, wake up the birth canal and to the left, just waking her up and then meeting her and say, I love you and sending affirmations into her, she'll wake up as opposed to down there somewhere. No, she's right here. And she needs all your attention and your care and she will stay with you all the days of your life. So womb yoga lifts up the uterus. So those women who are suffering from prolapsed uterus, as you get older, your uterus will drop, and they went. The only thing the medical field feel like they can do is take out the uterus. They'll say, "Do you have any children? You don't have. Oh well, go ahead and have a child quick." Or just got to find a mate because we have to do a hysterectomy because your uterus is dropping. But you can pull it up. The muscles want to bring, you know, come up. And then women heavy bleeding. You know, in yoga practice, it's really yoking everything. I remember I spoke at Omega Institute and I was so anxious, I want to do my yoga. And it was a yoga weekend. 4 or 5 of the women were there. And they said, "We want you to just talk about a yoga way of life." Well, I said, "I have yoga. I have a," and they said, "We would like for you to just calm down and talk about the yoga way of life." I said, "No problem." If, you know, vegetarian, working with herbs, working meditation, affirmation, clearing out your heart, drinking your water to save flesh. So I talked about lifestyle. But now it's the time has come for me to fully bring out yoga. And it's not like I'm pushing it. It's people are asking more and more about it. Yeah. So I'm really excited.
Yeah.
Thanks for asking.
Of course. And I love that too. I mean, I want to get excited too. It's like when they're like, calm down. It's like, no, I want to do it. I want to be guided. Tell me what to do. Now I can see why all those people are like, can you come live with us? I want to come with you too. Just tell me all of the things. I really am. I think this is such a gift. And I really do at times when I'm learning about all of these things, wish that we would learn this in school. Or that it's something that would be taught, especially for young women to learn the efficacy of all of this work, or just learning about yourself. I mean, I've learned more about my own body in the last 2 years, having to go through this process, than I have my entire life. And I just think that's so bizarre. I mean, it shouldn't be that way, right? Yeah. Yeah. That's true. Yeah. Because, you know, we were sort of for, I mean, I don't want to say forced. I mean, I'm like, I don't want, we were forced.
We were inspired. We were pushed over the cliff.
Yeah.
Come to your family. Some people are not adjusting to well-being with their families. Like it's just, that's the deep part.
Yeah.
Wow. I mean, I remember I saw one on social media. She was sitting in her car to get a break from her children. And she was smoking and stressing. These children, they're driving me crazy. They're going to get something. They're going to figure out something about this virus because I can't do this. I thought, whoa, okay. And people are fighting in families with their toxic.
Yeah.
So, you know, they have to do some of this work. We tell them so they won't be taken off the ledge. Won't be so stressed out.
Yeah. And I really do feel like a lot of that tension and anxiety and toxicity comes from within, right? And you talk about this, the importance of cleansing from the inside out.
Oh my gosh. I think I grew up with you because we're having a certain conversation. I know you so well. Okay. Because I was probably the only African-American or Black woman in the circle, often in the circles. So I know the circles, I know you. And so we're having this wonderful conversation. Detoxification, that is what saved my life. I started this when I was 16 years old and I had asthma, chronic asthma, eczema from head to toe, heavy menstrual bleeding, 8 days. I was bedridden, I was sick, I was nauseous, I was throwing up, it was a mess. I had arthritis, I had headaches, all that was happening in my body. And I was trying to be an artist in the midst of this body so toxic. So I did start through the detox, but I didn't know I was coming to detox. My best girlfriend, she was a vegetarian already. And she told me about this healing retreat. And I went on a retreat without my medication. I don't know what I was thinking, but I think the Most High guided me to trust me. When I got off the bus, I had no meds. The asthma kicked in, the allergies kicked in. I'm wheezing, I'm breathing heavy. Oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? And I was like, at the level, I was embarrassed to be sick. So when I asked that deep question, I got the answer immediately. That's when I didn't know I was connected to spirit at the time. We call God, Almighty Jah, Jehovah, Allah. And the Most High within me said, my first formula, it was to detox me. Mm. Eat the grapefruits there. There was a bowl of fruits, oranges, water. And then I picked up some rose hips tea. I'll never forget that tea. And then that whole day I was drinking water. That was my first detox. That night I couldn't lay down like everybody else was laying in bed because my lungs were just collapsed on me because I was still wheezing. Mm. And I propped up a pillow just like I'm sitting here now. And then there was a fireplace that was heated up the whole night. And I didn't realize that that he was like a sweat lodge. So I was detoxing with the heat coming in. And then I had the citrus and the water that was flushing out this congestion that was wrapped around my lungs and my sinus. That next morning, I went through the ultimate detox. I didn't know what it was called that until years later. And that was when it just came out my nose, my mouth, my eyes. All of a sudden, the asthma stopped. I said, wait a minute. It was like a hurricane hit you and then all of a sudden it stopped the day after. That's how my body just stopped. The fear in my mind, it just went to total calmness. And I was no longer scratching. I was looking like a junkie. I was no longer scratching. I said, wait a minute. It clicked. I had my aha moment. There must be something to how I'm living and what I'm eating. I think I can get well. You mean I don't have to be sick? I was in the bathroom for an hour. Mucus, mouth out of mouth, out of my nose, everything was coming. And when I came out, I was like, whoa, what happened? And I remember I picked up one book to transform my life. Well, two books. One was Dick Gregory, Cooking with Mother Nature. And there was another book that was just top of my head. It will come to me. But that was the main book. And I related to his 9 children, all vegetarians, and him and his wife. And then I saw the people that was teaching that weekend. Everything I learned that weekend, I'm doing now. It was doing yoga, meditation, agriculture, and herbal walks, and vegetarian food cuisine, and all of that. And I went home a complete vegetarian. It's like overnight. I didn't have to make, I made no transition. I stopped eating more dairy. I stopped eating more animal products. I stopped eating more fried foods. I stopped eating more sugar. Complete let go, detox. And I learned as I was going and as I was studying and I became certified, but I was detoxing for 2 21-day cycles. And everything that I mentioned, the arthritis, the PMS, of course, the asthma had started lifting, it all left in 2 months. That was the ultimate detox. After that, I became like a holistic evangelist. And I started telling people, listen, I'll see somebody limping in the shirt. I said, listen, you need some clay on that leg. You'll be okay. I called up all my mother's friends. I called up all my friends. I went to my black book. I said, listen, I know you've been going through these problems, but you can't get well. Just do this and do that and do that. And it got so deep till I made 500 flyers. I got on my bike. I'm a biker. And I got on my bike and I put flyers on the doors at food co-ops and people's doorways everywhere in the neighborhood, Brooklyn, New York. And one person came. It didn't discourage me. I talked for 8 hours to that one person about detoxification. I was convinced that the world, my community, the communities of the whole planet needs to detox. I guess what's happening right now with the pandemic, people are beginning to wake up, they need to detox. So it took me 50 years to get to this point, but you know, I have time.
Yeah, and here we are. Plenty. Yeah, plenty. Oh, I love that so much. That makes me so happy. And it's so inspiring and so encouraging. I remember I did the same thing. You know, I'm trying to teach about holistic health, healthy eating. I'm trying to teach yoga in this, you know, kind of lower income community with people that don't even speak English, you know, and I'm just like, this is good. This is good for you. And like, nobody would want to listen or do the things. But yeah, I mean, that makes me so happy because I know that there are, you know, powerful leaders like yourself who are out there still doing this work. And I feel like I see the amount of people that are wanting this information now, that are doing these things, that are seeing the information, that see the efficacy of following a more holistic path. So thank you for that. I want to be respectful of your time, and I'm just so again honored to have you on the show and be able to talk to you about these things. I have too many questions to ask you. We're just going to have to do this again. So I wanted to ask you the final question, but before I do that, is there anything that you want to share with the audience, or maybe you want to just direct people to where to go, where they can get in touch with you, or where they can go buy your books or your products?
Well, thank you so much. I really enjoyed you to the utmost. This is the season, you know, Women's History Month. Yesterday was my daughter's birthday. She's born March 8th, Women's International Day. And spring cleaning time, spring equinox. This is a wonderful time for us to all blossom. So everyone should go on a detox and go on a fast. Move from toxic eating to a vegetarian, to a 7-day vegetarian lifestyle. Or 7 days of live food, that's what I recommend for everyone. Or 7 days of juice therapy. But give yourself at least 7 days. You may go to 21. And after that, you may say, my gosh, I feel so great. I want to take this as a way of life. So start 7 days. So I'd say, you know, check my website, www.queenofbula.com, and get your 7-day detox kit. I have a kit. It's been out for the last 35 years. It's family produced, handcrafted. We have the Green Life nutritional formula. So you know, we wake up sometimes tired after 8 hours of sleeping because we're malnourished. And then I have in the formula, your master herbal. And that's to help to detox you from the cravings. We want to change our diet, but we're addicted to what we were raised with. So we clean out the blood, you clean out the cravings. Then I was a colon therapist for 15 years. I retired, but I encouraged colonic irrigation and colon wellness, clean out the gut, the colon. And so I have two formulas, the colonies and a herbal laxative, to flush out that old waste and back up in your system and come out through your skin and your emotions. And then I have the rejuvenation clay in your kit. If you have any aches and pains and swelling, you just pack it back, shoulders, womb, headaches, wherever, and keep that on overnight when you go to sleep at night. And now pull the poisons out, put the minerals in. And then the breath of life for the lungs. And it's all plant-based. All nature. I didn't create it. Nature did. I just gathered it together, and I know what's best. And so, with that, I give you a manual, so you have all your menu. You have a menu plan to follow. You have your day to day checklist. I treat it like if you have a retreat. So I don't call this that you're being like put away when you go home. I look at this as a retreat time. So we've been on retreat for the last 5 or 6 months. Did you write your book? Did you create a whole new curriculum? So make this like, wow, I am here and I'm going to create everything I want to create because I'm home now. So you can do your 7-day detox with me. And then I have also, I'm so excited about it goes with it. It's 21-day detox your life. I walk you through the home. I go in the nutrition kitchen and I say, these are the things you do in the nutrition kitchen. These are some of the recipes, about 20 of them. I walk you over to your bathroom, which I call the hydrotherapy room. And this is all the wonderful things you do in your hydrotherapy room to reduce stress and let go of the toxins and give energy. I walk you over to the living room where you do your journaling and you do your movements and you do your affirmations and your meditation. And then I finally walk into the bedroom where you do your inversion every day, which I talked about earlier. So your home now is your wellness home. That you should get excited about that, having a wellness home. And to me, that's like the ultimate. And you're the healer of your home and you're healing your family. And you can still see your doctor. I'm not saying telling what I mean. This is a disclaimer. If you're seeing your doctor, please continue seeing your doctor, your physician. But you know, meanwhile, take care of yourself, food is medicine, eat well, eat whole. And when you go see your physician will probably, you know what? You're doing so well, maybe you should cut back on your medication. Oh my goodness, you're doing miraculously much better. So maybe we'll hold off on that surgery. And then maybe you don't need to have it because you're doing so beautifully. So that's what I want to share with everybody. And I look forward to you getting my book and giving me your critique on Mesh Connect, the last gateway, birthing your purpose.
Oh, I love it. So great. Okay. So thank you so much, Queen Afua.
Thank you. You are so incredible.
So here's the final question. I'm so excited to hear what your response is going to be. So this is for everybody who's been on the show. I always ask the same question. The show is called Radically Loved because I wanted to create a space where people can go to get inspired. And the idea is that we are radically loved by God, Source, Buddha, whatever higher power of your understanding, the universe works for us and not against us. So the final question for you is, how do you feel radically loved?
I feel it through, I call it impeccable listening. The Most High, all the names, as you said, all the spiritual paths, the answer's already in us. If you ask the question, you already have it. So if you just ask from inside, not everyone outside, but ask from inside, you can still get quiet. Take a deep breath and just ask. And what you hear, move with it. Not emotion. You'll start to feel that because it's everything is already there. So have radical listening. If you start listening, you'll start walking on a love path. Everywhere you go, you're going to find love. You'll be guided. Don't go that way. Go this way. Don't say yes. Say no. Oh, sign this off. Don't. You'll be given step by step what to do. That's love. To be guided into a life of joy and wellness and vitality. That's radical to live like that every day. No matter what has happened, no matter what is going on, to live like that. And that becomes love from you. Pours out like that pebble you put into the pond that reverberates out, that same pebble of listening from deep within, and constantly, no matter what happens, you just keep listening and you keep being guided, and your love starts to grow and your peace starts to grow, and everywhere you turn, love is there. I mean, this was one thing that's affirming. I moved into this complex where I am now, and I was setting up my yoga studio. I have a large enough patio to set my yoga studio outside. And I was putting the pillows up and the yoga mat, I'm all blissed out. And my neighbor, two apartments down, he waved to me and I waved back. He says, "We love you here." I said, "Oh my gosh." I said, "I have never heard you." I said, "You know what? I love you too. Come to my yoga studio when I do." I mean, that's kind of radical. That was very but I felt so good. I know that if you feel good, goodness will spread.
Yeah.
I love that radical place, because that's what time it is. It's time to shift now.
Yes. Oh, I love it. I love you so much. Thank you so much, Queen Afua. You are so incredible. I'm so grateful to you, to everybody, your team, your family, everybody in your life who has supported you to create what you have for all of us. Thank them. Thank you. And for everybody listening to this show, we hope you enjoyed it. Please pick up this book and all of Queen Afua's products. Please go to her website. There's so much information there. There's so many products that can set you on your path. Please go there and support. And we're so grateful for all of you listening and for continuing to support us. So thank you. That's our show. Thank you all so much. Thank you, Mod Pod. Thank you again, Queen Afua.
Thank you. I adore you. I adore this interview. I adore you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I am so excited to continue to do this. Please share this with your friends. Email us, message us on Instagram at Rosie Acosta or on Twitter at Rosie Acosta. Subscribe on iTunes, write a review. We love doing this, so please help us continue to keep this podcast going. Thanks for listening.